Hello students. Students, today we will going to start with a new chapter, that is Albert Einstein at School, written by Patrick Pringle. So this is the chapter from your snapshot book, and before I start with line to line explanation of this chapter, I would like to give you a summary. I would like to tell you the summary of this chapter. So first of all, the main characters in this chapter are Albert Einstein. He was a student, and it was the story of the young Einstein, right? Next is Mr. Braun. Mr. Braun was his history teacher at Albert School, and he basically used to say that Albert, you are a disgrace for school. Third is Yuri. Yuri was his friend of Albert in Munich, and he really helped Albert a lot. Next is Mr. Koch. Mr. Koch is a mathematics teacher at Albert School, and he, at the last, you will going to know that he was the one. He was his maths teacher, and he was the one who actually know that yes, Albert will going to do a lot in his future. So he was very much foresighted, and he saw that qualities in Albert and made him realize that you are not meant for this school. You have to go more and more higher. Next is landlady. Landlady is a woman who rented a room in a house to Albert. Next is head teacher. Head teacher is the headmaster of the school, and in the last, he used to, he used to expel Albert from the school. Then Dr. Ernest Well. Dr. Ernest Well is a doctor who specializes in nerves. And he give a medical certificate of nervous breakdown to Albert. And the last is Alsa. Alsa is Albert's cousin. So here the story starts with that Einstein was studying in a German school in Munich. And at that time, his teacher, Mr. Braun, asked him that in which year, he asked this question from Albert, that Albert, just tell me in which year Napoleon was defeated by Waterloo by Prussians. So what happened at this time, the boy, he just confuses, and he didn't know the year, and he think that he must have forgotten. So the teacher wanted to know that if Albert ever tried to learn. Then what happened, what he got in reply, what the teacher got in reply is that with very honesty, Albert tell him that, see, sir, there is no point in learning dates. Means dates are all what factual things. He argued that one can always look up the dates in book. Means whenever you want to know the dates, you can always go up into the book and you can see in which date the war started. So there is no sense, according to me, according to Albert, there is no sense of learning dates, learning facts, which was actually not aim of his education. So then with a very sarcastic manner, then teacher Mr. Braun, he just asked that, Albert, okay, it's not your aim of education, then just you tell me what is your theory of education. So here the Albert reply was that, sir, he just told to everyone that, see, it's more important to know the ideas. Means it's more important to go with the ideas rather than to learn with the dates or facts. Means I would rather like to know why soldiers killed one and another, what was the reason behind that, rather than learning dates. So obviously the teacher became very angry, and he just shouted to Albert, and he just said that, Albert, do you know you are a disgrace to school, and you just ask your father that he should better take away from you from this school. I mean, you are just wasting others and yours time. as well as yours money too. So he just said that it's better you just go away from your from this school. So what happened when he was going to his home at that time, Albert felt very miserable, and of course there it was a very bad day for him because his class teachers called him very badly, and he said that you are a disgrace to school. So he didn't feel like going back to this hateful school every morning, because he didn't find that this school is actually fruitful, right, for him, because his concept was not to mugging up, his concept was to know the ideas, right, rather than to mug up. So of course he thought that his father was not take him away from the school until and unless if he will not going to complete his diploma. So of course, so this was the biggest thing. So when he just went to room, he was living in a very poorest part of Munich. It was just like a slum area. So he also hated that place because of slum atmosphere, because the people used to shout like from each other, they used to abuse. In fact, his landlady beat her children regularly, and on weekend she herself was thrashed by her drunken husband. In fact, in the weekend his husband used to come drinking a lot and beat her. So what happened, he decided that anyhow I just want to get rid of from the school and from this area. So he thought that it's better to ask from his friend Yuri. So Albert was lucky that he is having a very sincere friend, Yuri. His name was Yuri. So he discussed all his problems of schooling as well as logging with him, right? He even doubted that if he would ever pass the examination or if he would ever get the diploma. So he even discussed this problem with cousin Elsa when she came to Munich. So what happened at that time, Elsa, she just advised him that just learn by heart and just repeat what he learned in the examination, because I have saw many people, I mean they are so foolish but they still get their diploma, and you are far more better than them. So definitely if you will going to learn, you will going to pass your examination, right? But now here the Albert told Elsa, see Elsa, the problem was with me is that I'm not good learning things by heart. So what happened at that time when like Elsa and Albert was like having conversation, so Elsa inquired that Albert, which book you are carrying under your arms? So he tell that it was a book on geology and it's a one textbook. Okay, so here he told that I studied it because he liked that subject, right? The second interest Albert was having is in music, so he always used to play violin, right, whenever he used to go room, because he find that the peace by singing or by playing music. Until and unless his landlady came to Albert and asked him to stop that violin, that instrument. So then what happened afterwards, Albert find that this is now the fullest for me and I cannot go to school anymore. So he consulted his friend Yuri and he said that he must get away from here, right? Because it was actually an absurd for him that he should waste his father's money. So because he wanted to go to Milan, Italy for his higher studies. So he just requested his friend Yuri that if Yuri can provide any certificate, doctor certificate, that he had a nervous breakdown and he must leave the city. If Yuri will going to help him, then definitely the doctor will going to give me this medical certificate. So Yuri said that I'm having one friend of mine that who is Dr. Ernest Well, though he was not a specialist in nervous disorders, but still he will guide you. So he asked Albert, when both of them they just went to doctor at that time, the doctor asked Albert that, see Albert, whatever I'm asking, please be honest, whatever going in your mind, don't lie at all. So when the doctor see the situation, when the doctor saw everything, he just agreed to certify that Albert was really facing with nervous breakdown, and it was actually a real. First he just tried that he should get a certificate, and that certificate he should give to school, and with this certificate he will going to get the leave. But actually the problem was that with this situation, because he was so much upset, he was so much distressed with this situation of his, he was feeling with nervous breakdown. So doctor get to know that he was in a state of nervous breakdown, right? And he must stay away from school for at least 6 months. So the doctor, he just gave the certificate, and the doctor didn't charge any fee for his service, as like he was like the friend of Yuri, right? So here Yuri said that Albert, 6 months was pretty long period. Then Albert said that, yes, I will be leaving the school, but I will come back for the diploma. After getting the certificate, what happened? Albert, he just planned to take that medical certificate to the head teacher to the next day, right? But Yuri advised Albert that before, giving to the head teacher, first get a reference in writing from your mathematics teacher. Mathematics teacher was Mr. Coach. And Mr. Coach, he was the one who really appreciated Albert, who really know that Albert was the one who know more than enough. Right, so he said one thing that Albert, I mean it is actually a very big thing that I am teaching you, and I'm afraid that after few years, I mean you are so knowledgeable person, you are so intelligent person, that you will going to teach me. So Mr. Coach knew his, he knew everything, he knew his capabilities, he knew his abilities, that what his Albert too. So what happened? Mr. Coach, he just agreed with Albert that he will going to, give the reference letter. And afterwards, when Mr. Coach, he just give the certificate to Albert, Albert now finally was ready to join the college for study of higher mathematics. Then the last is when he got the certificate from his mathematics teacher, then the final stage come that he want to give the medical certificate to his head teacher. So finally the head teacher, he just went to the head teacher, and at that time all of a sudden what happened, the head teacher, in fact he called Albert. So Albert was like happy that it's good that at least head teacher called me, I don't have to waste my time by waiting. So he just went there, and when he went into his office, all of a sudden he just shouted to Albert, and he just wanted to say that Albert, it's better you just leave the school at once. It was a, you can say it was a sort of expulsion. Means he was like rusticated from school. So Albert was not getting at that time that why head teacher had made such a big decision. And head teacher was saying that, Albert, you always refuse to learn. You was a constant, you know, rebellion. You always used to say no. Whenever a teacher asks you a question, you never find it interesting. You never find it learning dates. So at that very moment, without saying a word, Albert, he just declared that he was actually going to leave, right? And without saying anything, he just walked out of the office and the school where he spent 5 miserable years. So this was a big thing. So here he thinks that it's better that the head teacher, in fact, he have said that get lost from the school. Means I don't have to give, you know, the medical certificate also. Then when he just met his friend Yuri, he just, you know, gave him a good wishes. He just gave him a good luck. And he hoped that Albert would be more and more happier in Milan, Italy. And he will going to do his best. So this is the end of the chapter, Albert Einstein and at school. So here you can say that how, you know, Albert Einstein is not good in learning dates or facts, but he wanted in actual life, you know, he wanted the actual life knowledge. And knowledge is the most important thing that Albert, you know, that make Albert Einstein and Albert Einstein, right? So this is what the story. So students, this is what the story is trying to convey, how in his school everyone used to think that he didn't study or he's not allowing everyone to study, but he actually achieved something in life. And after all, criticism, he decided to do what he likes.